We're looking at a piece of software called Stellarium. Okay, so we look up at the sky and face north, and there we go. Everything is rotating anti-clockwise around Polaris. Now, if we face south, then in the planisphere projection, which is very much like what you would actually see, as opposed to some of the other projections that you can commonly see, which don't reflect what you would actually see very closely. But in this projection, when we look south and we stand in the UK, we see the stuff sort of drifting across the sky. It's not a rotation in our field of view looking here really good. It's a sort of flow of stars here from left to right. Okay, so what happens in this projection if I visit Australia or New Zealand? So we click down to New Zealand, and in New Zealand I'm now going to face, so at the moment I'm facing south. Okay, so in New Zealand facing south, what do we see? We see the stars rotating clockwise. And I'm facing south. And they're rotating clockwise around the pole. Okay. So that matches up with what we would expect to see. A clockwise rotation as opposed to an anti-clockwise rotation, which you see in the northern hemisphere. And when I turn around and I look north, what do I see? I see the kind of flow of stars from one side of the sky to the other, going the opposite direction. So what's the point of what I've shown you? Well, it shows you that in the planisphere projection, there's only one axis of rotation going on. So the stars are only circulating around one point. And when you look in the other direction, they are not circulating around a point at all. Okay, so that is what we observe in both hemispheres, except that the direction is reversed. So we see things rotating around when we look north in England, or when we look south in New Zealand. So we're led to believe that that's because in New Zealand, so if you're in New Zealand, you think you're looking towards the South Pole, because South Pole doesn't exist in the flat Earth model. When you're looking south in New Zealand, you're looking to what us in Europe and say England, the UK, is north. So if you look south in New Zealand, you're really looking north from a UK person's perspective. And if you're looking north from a New Zealand perspective, you're looking south from a UK perspective. So if you look at the flat Earth map, you can see why that is. Because the north and south are opposing each other, they're 180 degrees apart. So it doesn't enter into anyone's minds to think about this in the globe model, because of course in the globe model they don't think they're looking at the same thing, they think they're on the bottom of the world. So what I've showed you explains how in a flat Earth model you would observe exactly the same phenomena as you see in the spherical world model. So I can go to Australia and see what I'm told I'm going to see, the rotation around what I'm told is a south pole when I look south, and a kind of indistinct kind of flow of stars when I look north, and in the northern hemisphere I'm seeing what I should. So I see what I should when I'm in what I think is the appropriate hemisphere.
What we see above our heads is the result of being on a flat Earth. So let's just take a look at how that can be worked out.
The dog's seen all this before, not impressed anymore. Let's have a look now at how this would affect star trails. So I'm looking up at the stars or the sky as if I'm somewhere north of the equator, not quite up to the North Pole, and just take a note of the direction that the blades appear to be turning from left to right. They're going across from the left to the right of the screen. Okay, now I'll just give this another spin and I'll step over here as if I'm crossing the equator and turning around and facing back north. I'm now south of the equator and you can see that the fan blades appear to be going from the right to the left. They haven't changed their direction of spin, but I've changed my orientation to look at it. Okay, go back under and turn around. And now the blades are going from left to right again. You see, north of the equator, left to right, south of the equator, right to left. Thank you very much.